Yes, we have almost reached the end of the chapter. So that was where the king had asked his men to arrange a stake where they would be able to execute the merchant. But luckily, or you may say unluckily, the merchant did not fit in the noose. Now the search was to find out the one who would fit in the noose, the one who would be, whom they would be able to fit in that stake. Right? Is this what justice is? No. Let's see now what the king does. So I'm on page number 23. Am I right? Okay, 25. So the king was now thrown into deep thought. He didn't want to lose the kingdom to someone else in the next round of life. He needed time. So when he was in search of somebody who would be like, whom he would be able to fit in the noose, eventually they got that fat disciple. Right, fat disciple, the moment he was in trouble, he remembered his guru. So at the time when you people listen to me only, you listen to me. So the fat man, that is a disciple, when he was in trouble. So it happens when we are in trouble, we always remember the ones who might have taught us some wisdom. And our first guru is usually our mother. So whenever we are in trouble, we remember our mother. Am I right? So, but this disciple might not have his mother and all. His guru might be his everything. So when he was in trouble, then he remembered his guru. And the guru was with him within no time. So here the guru came physically, but actually, what is the significance of this matter? What do you learn from this lesson? The moment you remember your teacher or your guru or your parents in trouble, you will get a solution because of what they might have taught you. Okay, the parents, maybe mother, father, or maybe the teachers, gurus. They always teach you people something or the other. And when we are in trouble, we can remember, we may make out like what they said, what was the solution. So that solution can save us. And here the guru came physically, but it is symbolic of the fact like the teachers or the parents, their advice or their wisdom can make us, can save us from any problem. Got it? So the guru came there. Guru was very wise, as you already know. So the moment he reached there, he said something in his ears. Whose ears? Disciples. He said something in his ears. What do you think he might have said? Okay, the guru might have told him the solution of the problem. Or, okay, that's not wrong. It's okay. What else?
Might have been a plan.
Yeah, that is correct. What's your name? Raghav. And today again, Raghav is there. So silent clapping for him. Yes. So anyone who will give me the correct answer, maybe wrong answer, I don't mind. Because when you will speak something, it means that you are attentive. Okay, for attentiveness, we will be there to appreciate you. Okay, so don't bother whether your answer would be wrong, never mind. Try to give answer. Okay, so point was like, what he might have said to him in the ears? The king might have told him the plan, with which he was thinking they, that they would save him. So it might have been about the plan. He might have told him, ki, like, whatever I say, support me. That's it. He might not have told him the whole story. He might have only said, like, be with me. Right? Okay. Then king told the king, what was the plan? He told the king, like, sir, first of all, please execute me. Then you execute that man. King, being foolish, thought like there is something. This, if this man is wanting to be hanged, then there is some good. Then there is some plan. Though there was a plan, but if something wants to die, what good can he be having in that? The king, being foolish, thought that there might be some good in it. So he asked the guru to explain why he wanted to be executed. That was his another foolishness. Don't ask explanations from those people from whom you should not. Okay? But that person, king, being foolish, asked the guru to explain. He did not know that he was a very wise guru. He did not know this. Okay, let's see now what the guru will do. I think we had read out that part. Okay. So I'm reading that paragraph again. The guru and the disciple now got into a fight about who should go first. The king was puzzled by this behavior. He asked the guru, why do you want to die? We chose him because we needed a fat man for the stake. You shouldn't ask me such questions. Put me to death first, replied the guru. Why? There is some mystery here. As a wise man, you must make me understand. Will you promise to put me to death if I tell you? Asked the guru. The king gave him his solemn word. What do you mean by he gave him his solemn word? He promised him. Okay? What's a solemn word? Promise. Otherwise, solemn literally means serious, grave. What can be the serious word? Promise. The guru took him aside out of the servant's earshot and whispered to him, do you know why we want to die right now? The two of us, we have been all over the world, but we have never found a city like this or a king like you. That stake is the only stake of the God of Justice. It's new. It has never had a criminal on it. Whosoever dies on it first will be reborn as a king of the country. And whoever goes next will be the future minister of the country. We are sick of our ascetic life. What is ascetic life? The life of a saint. The life of a person who has got detached from everyone. So he says that we are fed up of our life of a saint. It would be nice to enjoy ourselves as a king and the minister for a while. Now keep your word, my lord, and put us to death. Me first, remember? So the king told the guru told the king his plan. He told him, like, sir, this very stake where you are going to hang us, there has never been a criminal before. And anyone whosoever will be hanged first will become the king. And the one who will be hanged second will become the minister. So our planning is that we want to become king and minister in our next birth. Right? Right? The king was now thrown into deep thought. He didn't want to lose the kingdom to someone else in the next round of life. He needed time. So he ordered the execution postponed to the next day and talked in secret with his minister. So what happened when the guru told him this thing? What happened last girl? What's your name, beta? Arpit? Huh, stand up. Yes, come here. Have you got your book with you? Have you got the book?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So tell us, what happened? What did we discuss right now?
Ma'am, we are discuss about the things that we are discuss about the things that we.
A bit louder.
About the things, about the foolish and wise.
What did the guru do? What did the guru do to save his disciple? Why? You should. Yes, the second last Lavanya. Come here. So what did the guru do to save his disciple?
Ma'am, instead of the disciple, the guru decided to hang on the rope, and he whispered something in his ears to support him.
Okay, well done. Put your seat. Quiet, will you try? What did the guru do to save the disciple? In one word, in one line. Gurshan? Gurpal? The question is, what did the guru do to save the disciple?
The guru proved a solution that if we make the king fool by saying that the first who will be hanged, whom will be hanged first will be the next king of the next
will be the future king
and whom will be hanged second will be the future minister.
Well done. Yes, silent clap for him also and Lavanya also. Well done, both of you. Okay. Vyash, yes, listen to me. It was a simple answer. The guru offered himself to be hanged to save the disciple. Actually, it was his planning that he would tell the king that the one who will be executed first will become the king in the next round of life, and the one who will be executed second will become the minister. The guru actually knew that the king was a foolish, and devising such kind of foolish plan would only make him save the not only disciple but the whole country. Got it? So if you want to trap foolish people, you must have a plan in which the foolish people get trapped. You cannot tell them nice things with which they can be won over. Okay. Yes, you are right, Jia and Janvi. Your answer is correct. So now, the king, when he got to know the planning of the... When he got to know the planning of the disciple, he started thinking. And now he thought, like, if that he only should become the king next. He started thinking, and he, number one, postponed the trial. He postponed the hanging. And he thought, like, what will he think naturally? You know, he's a fool. You mind your business. Okay, he cannot. So what happened? The king started thinking and he thought, like, if they would become the king next, then what will happen to him? So the main thing is that he only wants to become the king, but the foolish king forgot that he is already the king. Okay, unless and until he dies, how can somebody else become the king in the next round of life? Right? So the foolish king, he will be taken in by the plan of the guru. So, okay, it's not right for us to give over the kingdom to others in the next life. Let's go on to stake ourselves and we'll be reborn as king and minister again. Holy man, do not tell lies, he said, and the minister agreed. So what did he plan? He planned that instead of letting the guru and the disciple be executed, let us hang ourselves. Because he wants that he only would be becoming the king in the next life. But how really foolish. He forgot that he was the king in this very life also. Okay. So he told the executioners, we will send the criminals tonight. When the first man comes to you, put him to death first. Then do the same to the second man. Those are my orders. Don't make any mistake. Got it? So he told his men that the very first man, whosoever comes, execute him first. And whosoever comes second, execute him second. So what is his planning? His planning is that he would reach there first. So his planning is to get himself executed. Why does he want to execute himself? Why does he want to get himself executed? Executed means hanged. When you talk for 1 minute, 1 second, you skip one concept. Otherwise, you are listening to me. You know, sit straight. Leave your arm from the behind that desk. Yes. So what was the plan, Ansha? Good. Right. So the point is that he offered himself to be executed first to save, to become the king in the next round of life. Right. Sit down. It was such a noisy fan. Okay. So he told the executioners, we'll send the criminals tonight. When the first man comes to you, put him to death first, then do the same to the second man. Those are my orders. Don't make any mistake. That night, the king and minister went secretly to the prison, released the guru and the disciple, disguised themselves as the two, and arranged beforehand with the loyal servants, were taken to the stake and promptly executed. So what are disguised? So at night, what did the king and the minister do? They went to the prison, right? So they disguised themselves as the two. First of all, they released the guru and the disciple. They let them secretly go. Then they started being there in the guise of guru and disciple. What is the disguise or guise of? In the dress up and appearance like that. Okay. The thief entered the house disguised as a saint. Got it? Disguised means when you try to cheat somebody in the dress and appearance like somebody else. Disguised as. So the king and his minister, they disguised themselves as a guru and the disciple there. And next morning, they were taken to the stake and they were promptly executed. Got it? When the bodies were taken down to be thrown to crows and vultures, the people panicked. They saw before them the dead bodies of the king and the minister. The city was in confusion. All night, they mourned and discussed the future of the kingdom. Okay. Throughout the night, they kept on mourning. The what is mourning? M-O-U-R-N-I-N-G. M-O-U-R-N-I-N-G. Mourning means? It's not good morning. M-O-U-R-N-I-N-G. When you mourn the death of somebody means when you condole the death of somebody. Okay? So they mourned the death of the king throughout the night. And in the morning, they discussed the future of the kingdom. Some people suddenly thought of the guru. 4 minutes are left. Wait. They saw them before. So at night, they mourned and discussed the future of the kingdom. Some people suddenly thought of the guru and the disciple and caught up with them as they were preparing to leave town unnoticed. We people need a king, and the minister said someone. Others agreed. They begged the guru and the disciple to be their king and the minister. It didn't take many arguments to persuade the disciple, but it took longer to persuade the guru. So disciple agreed within a minute, but the guru took some time to be convinced. Why? Why didn't the guru agree instantly to become the king? My question is, see, disciple agreed instantly. Okay, he said, I'll become the minister. Reason is obvious. Because he was actually greedy, you know. Now, we know that he was always greedy. And now if he's offered the seat of a minister, then he agreed. But the guru took a lot of time in getting convinced to become the king. Why didn't he agree instantly? Because he was? The guru basically was the one who was detached from the world. He was not at all greedy. He was not the one who wanted to enjoy the luxuries and comforts of life. Who are the gurus? Who are the saints? Those who don't have any interest in the worldly things. Maybe position, maybe power, maybe money. They don't want these things. They want? It's not about forest life. No. These saints, you know, they want a life which is away from power or pelf or money. They want a simple life. But that simple life doesn't mean that they let the people being in trouble. Okay? The first and foremost interest of the saints is the well-being of people. Okay? Welfare of people. So first of all, he was not greedy. He never wanted any position or money or luxuries. But yes, in the end, if he was convinced, that was for the welfare of people. Okay, sometimes the saints become the administrators, not because they want some position or money or something, but because they know that if they would be there in the power, then they would do something good for the public. Okay. But if somebody wants money and position and all, then those kinds of people are the biggest, you can say, biggest criminals of the world. Okay, last one paragraph, let's finish. So some people suddenly thought of the guru and the disciple and caught up. So they begged the guru and the disciple to be their king and minister. It didn't take many arguments to persuade the disciple, but it took longer to persuade the guru. They finally agreed to rule the kingdom of the foolish king and the silly minister on the condition that they could change all the old laws. So what condition did they put? That they would change all the previous laws. From then on, night would again be night and day would again be day. And you could get nothing of a doodoo. It became like any other place. So, and you won't get anything free or cheaper. So you'll have to pay for it. You'll have to work hard. Okay. Okay. That's it. Now you today go through the questions, write them down.